Alright, welcome back to my channel guys, and as I had told in the previous video, today we'll be going over some of the ways in which you can improve your performance if you have a lower end PC like mine. Currently I am running a GTX 1050 Ti with a Core i5-8400 and 16 gigs of RAM. So let's get started, let's just launch the editor. So you see, Unreal Engine 5 comes with all these great tools, but at the same time it does demand a newer generation of hardware, which of course every developer does not have. So in this video we'll be trying to get UE4 like performance in UE5 so that you guys can work with a smoother frame rate. So let's just start by creating a third person project. Once that's done, let's just wait for the editor to load again. And by the way guys, if you guys haven't joined my Discord server yet, the link will be down in the video description below. Make sure you guys are in, because that is where you get the first updates regarding both my videos as well as updates on my project Vengeance. So now we are in the map, and as you guys can see, or actually maybe I'll just turn on stat FPS. So stat FPS. So as you guys can see, the performance is pretty bad. We are getting anywhere between 20 and 30 frames, and that's with a blank level. With UE4, I would easily cross 200 frames with this hardware. So let's just improve slightly upon that. By changing your scalability to low, of course it'll improve, but I'll be showing you guys the other way. So head over to your project settings. And it's mostly shadows and reflections which cause the performance dips. So what you want to do is you want to head over and type in virtual shadows and disable those. So now clearly we gained about 10 frames, but this is still not workable and definitely not acceptable for a blank level like this. So coming back to your scalability again, your graphic settings. So if you do set it to high or low or something, it is going to improve your performance, but what you'll notice is on low, the game looks absolute garbage in Unreal Engine 5. I am actually assuming right now that this is more of an optimization issue and that we will definitely get at least a 20% performance improvement over time, because when I set my scalability settings to auto, it chooses epic for some reason. I don't know if it's a bug or is it an indication for coming performance enhancements, I don't know, but now we'll be looking at another solution to improve your performance. Alright guys, so before we head any further, I just wanted to let you guys know that I would be making a full tutorial series for UE5. We'll be covering both single player as well as multiplayer aspects, and we'll be making an entire game from scratch, so make sure you guys are subscribed if you want that series. And yeah, let's start tweaking some more settings. Alright guys, so we are back to 40 frames a second. And now the improvement, I'll tell you, might not be liked by all of you. But if you do not care about graphical fidelity and you just want better performance because you're not able to run it, you could do this. So you have to disable Lumen basically. So all that dynamic global illumination is all gone. But you are going to get good performance. And moreover guys, it's not that big of a concern in this case, because the performance will stay good due to features like Nanite. I have added static meshes with lots of polygons, and Nanite seems to be handling that pretty well. So yeah guys, I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Thanks for watching. See you in the next one.